even though water is the majority of the beer in your glass, beer starts as a malted cereal grain. We make 30 barrels at a time here. 30 barrels is like a little less than 1,000 gallons. Most of the water is in the brewing stage. That's where we mix the water with the barley to make wort, and that's an aqueous product. We move that sweet wort from the mash tun to the boil kettle, and then we sparge. But it's also where we add hop. We add honey for our bock, where we can add a few different ingredients, just like cooking. That's our cool liquor tank. So it's where we have just like a refrigerated water holding at all times for cooling wort down. The rest of the heat exchanger, and then into our hot liquor tank, which is the water we will use to mash for the next brew, actually. So we're using a lot of water here, but it actually ends up getting used again. So it's like a net zero at that point. From boiling, you transfer it to your fermenter, where we add yeast and it ferments. That's 90 barrels of water. That's the process: grain, mash, boil, ferment, right tank, carbonation, package. The final product is usually more like 95 to 88% water by volume. But where we use probably more water is cleaning. We do a lot of cleaning around here. There's a joke in the industry that brewers are just glorified janitors, because really what we do most of the time is not brewing, it's cleaning our equipment. If we make 15,000 barrels in a year, that's 465,000 gallons. And we probably use about 5 gallons of water for every gallon of beer that we make. That's 2.3 million gallons of water that we would use. Beer requires a lot of water. Without that water, we would have 0 barrels.